Good morning. It's Cersei Denyer with District 52, and I'd like to walk you through the pathways path selection process. I want to show you some special things that you need to know when you're choosing your path. First thing you want to do is log in. I am logged in because you see my name, Welcome Cersei. If I was not logged in, this would say log in there. So that's step one. Log in to Toastmasters International. Once you're logged in, select Pathways, and then drop down to Choose a Path. Here are the menu items for choosing a path. You choose your language, and then it asks you, how would you like to access your materials? The digital resources online via Basecamp is one choice. Acquire printed materials in the mail for $25 extra is the second choice. Some of the paths in Pathways are in print, but not all of them. So you want to know what's in the printed materials. Let's say, for example, you decide that you don't like to be online learning. This might be the way you'd choose. You can compare the digital versus the print details. Several of the paths are available. There are five. You cannot access your educational materials online with the printed or do your online path assessment, but most of the traditional Toastmasters wouldn't need that. Paths available in translated languages, there are only two. But if it's English you're looking for, we have five. It costs $20 for your first path. However, if you've already been a member, that fee is waived and your first path is free. If you were in a more than one club at the time Pathways was rolled out and you're still in that club, that you can actually get a second path by calling Toastmasters International. Printed materials are $25 extra. You can still upload and store your evaluations. You can still earn and give digital feedback badges. And you can still have the same club experience that everyone else did. So let's look at the path options. This is where you're going to choose whether or not which path you decide you want. However, you have to make a choice up here first because not all of the paths are available in print. I'm going to choose digital resources. And now I'm going to continue. There are 11 paths in Pathways. Toastmasters International believes that most people are looking for to build their skills as an accomplished public speaker, so they recommend presentation mastery. I'm going to look at that path for just a moment because I'd like to point out some things about that. When you click on the plus that says learn more about presentation mastery, they give you a short introduction into what it is. And below that, they say view all projects in this path. When you click on that, it opens up the five different levels of presentation mastery in this Pathways program. Path one and level one and level two in presentation mastery are the same as other paths. Level one has the icebreaker, a section called evaluation and feedback, which is actually a speech. You get an evaluation on that speech. You use that evaluation to give a second speech that you also get evaluated for. Then you evaluate another speaker. That's the second set. The third set is researching and presenting. That's a larger project. It involves researching a subject, citing its sources, and delivering a speech about it. So level one is the same in all the levels. It's exactly the same. Level two is similar in most of the levels. This one has understanding your communication style, using effective body language, and introduction to Toastmasters mentoring. These three items are mandatory to complete level two. You'll notice that effective body language is something that's out of the competent communication manual. And you might ask where the other things are. Well, I'll show you. Of course, we know that the icebreaker was there, but inside evaluation and feedback is things like organize your speech, getting to the point. They talk about all those things right from the start in the educational materials for evaluation and feedback. On level three in presentation mastery, we have a mandatory project called persuasive speaking. If you'll remember, that was project 9 in the competent communication manual. Here are the elective projects. Level 3, 4, and 5 all have some mandatory elective projects. When you click on this box, it tells you how many and gives you a list of the choices. In this case, level 3 has you choose 2 of the following electives. So level 3 has 1 mandatory and 2 electives. So the total of 3 speeches. These are the choices that you have, and there's lots of them that may look familiar to you from either the competent communication manual or from the advanced manuals that you had probably seen. Level 4, building skills. The mandatory project is managing a difficult audience. The elective projects are these, and you only need to choose 1 of these. And there is no, before you we go any further, you can't get into these to see what they're about. You'd have to go somewhere else on Toastmasters to find out what these are about. Level 5, demonstrating expertise. There is a mandatory project in level 5 of presentation mastery called Prepare to Speak Professionally. Now, if you are not planning on speaking professionally, and that is not the reason that you're in Toastmasters, presentation mastery is probably not the path for you, because this project is not an elective. It is mandatory. Reflecting on your path is a project about reflecting on how all of this worked for you. So I want you to take a good look at the top row of all the paths. Find out what's mandatory in every single one, because in the electives, there's always something that works out in your favor, something that will fit your plan. But in the mandatory ones, you can't get beyond those paths until you complete the things that are mandatory. Let's look at another path. I'm going to go one step back. I'm going to look at engaging humor. Now, engaging humor is a path that is designed to help people gain skills on humorous speaking and to give them better skills as a speaker in any situation, because humor always, always makes it easier to engage your audience. So let's view all the projects in this path. It has 5 levels. Mastering the fundamentals is the same. Icebreaker, evaluation and feedback, researching and presenting. The 3 mandatory things in level 2 are know your sense of humor, connect with your audience, and introduction to Toastmasters mentoring. Level 3, the mandatory project is called engage your audience with humor. And let's look at the electives. They seem very similar to presentation mastery. I don't see any new ones in there. Level 4, building skills. The power of humor in an impromptu speech. This project is right out of one of the advanced manuals. There was an impromptu speaking project in a manual that was in the advanced projects. Here's the electives. These are similar to presentation mastery. And let's look at level five. Level five, under demonstrating expertise, the first mandatory project is deliver your message with humor. And the second mandatory one is reflect on your path. Under electives, again, you're only having to choose one of them. You have all of these choices. Some of them seem like leadership choices, ethical leadership, high performance leadership, leading in your volunteer organization. But then there's this one, lessons learned. So you can use the lessons learned path or project to complete level five's elective, even if you are not interested in any of the other choices. But if you are preparing to speak professionally by now and you're thinking that might work, you might want to do this one at the bottom. Once you've looked at all of these paths, and you've decided which one you like, which one fits your plan, all you need to do is choose it by selecting the one that you want and moving down to the continue button on the bottom. That takes you to the confirmation page where you continue. If this is a new path that you need to pay for, it'll take you to the checkout page. If it's your very first path, it will give you that path instructions and allow you to get started. I hope this has helped. Please, if you have any questions, please ask either our Pathways Chair at pathways@district52.org or myself, PQD@district52.org. Thank you for joining.